Indonesian authorities issue a tsunami warning after Sulawesi's Mount Ruang erupted late Wednesday. The volcano's eruption threw lava, rock, and ash as much as 3 kilometers into the sky. At least 800 people in North Sulawesi province were evacuated. For the first time in over a decade, a prime minister from New Zealand visits Manila. Christopher Luxon is now in Malacanang, where he's meeting with President Marcos. On the agenda, advancing the two countries' nearly 60-year relationship. Luxon is accompanied by a business delegation and a minister of climate change and revenue. Last year, New Zealand ranked as Manila's 28th largest trading partner, with total trade amounting to nearly $500 million. The Chinese embassy in Manila slams Philippine lawmakers for their malicious claims over the influx of Chinese students in Cagayan province. The embassy says the lawmakers are hyping up maritime issues to serve their political agenda and self-interest. It said these lawmakers' supposed concerns are intended to incite suspicion and hatred against China. Cagayan Representative Joseph Lara says he has received reports there are at least 4,600 Chinese students in one private university in Cagayan. Lara is seeking a House inquiry into the matter, citing possible risks to national security. He says he wants to hear from the Commission on Higher Education and the Immigration Bureau.
Ang tinuturo talaga nila after daw sa mga enrollees na ito, isusumiti daw nila ang report nila sa CHET. Kasi nga, yung proseso ang hinihingi ko sa kanila. Ano ba ang proseso ninyo? Ano bang status ng mga estudyanteng ito? Kasi in-invite din namin na kung pwede ang Bureau of Immigration.
But Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba said all the students have proper visas and they are in the province under a program of the Commission on Higher Education. The Chinese embassy in Manila insisting on the Philippines' alleged commitments concerning the West Philippine Sea. Beijing claims, aside from the so-called gentleman's agreement with former President Rodrigo Duterte, it also reached a consensus with representatives of the Marcos administration. Chinese and Filipino officials purportedly agreed on how to manage the Renai Zhao, which the Philippines calls a Yungin Show. The embassy claims the Philippine side unilaterally abandoned the agreement after one resupply mission. The embassy also denies China's gentleman's agreement with Duterte was done in secret. It maintains the Marcos administration knew about it from the time it took office. Marcos earlier insisted that no Duterte official informed him of any agreements with Beijing. And the Philippine Justice Department has asked Timor-Leste authorities for the immediate extradition or deportation of expelled Filipino lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. This is amid reports claiming the son of Teves allegedly bribed a member of the Timor-Leste police in exchange for special security inside and outside the prison. Teves was arrested while golfing in Dili last month. He's wanted for murder here in the Philippines in connection with the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and 9 others. The Metro Manila Development Authority ordered to suspend its crackdown on e-vehicles plying national roads for a month. President Marcos said the pause will allow the public to become aware of the new rule. The ban, which was implemented in a bid to lessen accidents involving e-bikes and e-trikes, took effect Monday. Violators faced a fine of 2,500 pesos, and some even had their vehicles impounded.
Dahil nakita ko naman na yung pag-enforce na napaka-stricto dun sa mga electric vehicles sa National Road, napapanood ko sila sa news. Nakakaawa naman talaga. Dapat bigyan naman natin sila ng pagkakataon para alam nila kung ano ba yung bagong rules, paano sila mag-adjust.